One of the biggest complaints about SmartSuite is that there is no front-end solution. If you're trying to build something in SmartSuite, there's not a good way to share it with other people, other users who you might want to grant access to without giving them access to SmartSuite itself. Well, thankfully now, there is such an integration, an amazing and simple tool to stand up called EasyPortal. So in this video, I'm going to be breaking down how you can leverage EasyPortal to put together a front end for your data that lives in SmartSuite, allowing you to share your SmartSuite interface with third-party users. If that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you get organized and automated with no code. One of our favorite tools is SmartSuite, and of course, if you leverage the power of SmartSuite and no code automation, you can start to save up to 20 hours of your time every week, thanks to automating those repetitive tasks and organizing your data in better, improved ways. Now, as I mentioned, we are going to be jumping into the front end option for SmartSuite, one of the first ones that has announced an integration with this new tool, and we are talking about EasyPortal. Now, before we get into it, I want to invite you to follow me along within your own SmartSuite account. Go ahead and open that up and also open up EasyPortal. You can sign up for a free account and join the early release beta today. And of course, if you're not already a SmartSuite user, use our affiliate link below to get signed up and show a little love back to the channel, but also make you available to exclusive SmartSuite swag if and when you upgrade your SmartSuite account in the future. So go ahead and use that link to get all squared away, and let's hop on into the video where we're gonna be walking through EasyPortal. All right, now first and foremost, I'm inside of a brand new EasyPortal account, and I can create a new portal. I like that they say portal because realistically what is being created anytime anybody uses a third-party interface is a portal to that backend data. So here we are after clicking just add a portal, and you see that I've got my default setup here. If I go on the left-hand side, I can examine my pages, and by default, a new portal starts with a home page, a table page, an about us page, and a sign-in page. Of course, we can add more pages as we need to our portal, but let's go ahead and drill into the table page because this is where we're gonna be sharing some information that already exists in a third-party source, in this case, SmartSuite. So we can go to that table and here it is. They've already added this element, which of course this particular tool calls a block. So when we're building our portals, every element that we're adding is a block. And when we click on that, we can see what the data source is, what the context is, what the actions are. We can assign actions to what happens when people do things inside of the block. And then also we can limit visibility. So who gets to see this stuff? Now, if you don't already have this block added, well, we can always recreate that very thing. So first let's come back and first delete this block. If we hover over the block again, we can just hit that delete and it's gone. So if you're starting from a blank slate like we are now, all we have to do is mouse over here, push the plus button for wherever we want to add that block. Let's go right on here. And then we get the selection of different types of blocks that we can add to this particular portal. I'll select dynamic here and we can find our option down here. So of course, as I mentioned, EasyPortal is in very early beta. So we don't have some of these more advanced features yet. No cards, calendars, lists, or forms, but you do note that they are coming. What we care about here though is pulling in that data from SmartSuite. We're gonna add the table block. Let's go ahead and make that selection right here and it's gonna drop it in. That's exactly what we had previously on the other screen. Now, we have to select our data source. Now, we haven't already synced up to SmartSuite, so let's do that for the first time. I will just say continue with Google and go ahead and sync up through my SmartSuite account that is accessed through my Google sign-in. And just like that, I have my integration with SmartSuite that I can select from the list. Now I have to select the workspace. I have a particular workspace in mind. If I flip over to it here in SmartSuite, this was built using the AI generator, by the way, for an invoicing solution. And I've got some sample data in here. And maybe I want to list out my clients inside of my portal so that when my team members are logging in to our portal, they can see our different clients and take action from there. So let's bring this information in. Back to EasyPortal, all I have to do is click my workspace and I need to find wherever that workspace is. I have a few different workspaces, you may as well, or you may just have one inside a SmartSuite. Now I have to drill into the solution. So I find the invoicing solution. Let's scroll on down, and I named it invoicing solution right here. And now lastly, the application, which we've called clients inside of there. Now, I originally thought that maybe views were optional. They are not. You must determine the view that you want to look at inside of EasyPortal to bring in that information. So let's flip back really quickly into SmartSuite. And if I look at my views, I only have the one grid view. Maybe I want to create a view that ranks things in alphabetical order. So let's do that. I'll create a new view. Grid view is fine. And I'll say alphabetical and create a view. And of course, now I need to bring in the data that I want to see. So for our example, maybe I want to display the name. I want to display the email and maybe the address as well and the phone number. Let's rearrange phone number and address here. Quick little click drag, click drop. And now I want to sort in alphabetical order by the name field. So I can click sort. Let's find that name field, wherever it is, right here. And I'll go from A to Z. So there we are. Of course, I am sorting by the first name in alphabetical order. So B, D, E, K, P, and S. So this looks good. I'm happy with this data. This is the view I want. Let's flip back to EasyPortal and find that view. Now it's not showing up because I just created it. So we first have to refresh our data pool. And now we will be able to find that alphabetical grid view. And I can bring it in here. And you can see that I start to get that information, but not quite yet. So I've told it what view I want to see, but I have not gone in and told it what content I want to include on this particular block. By default, it brought in a couple things, but some of it is a mess as well. So let's drill into the content. I flip onto content. This is my heading for my title. Of course, my title is showing up right here, the title in the table that is, but I can also apply this title up here and a subtitle. So I can say something like contact data. Here are the contacts. And now I'm going to include what items are being brought into this particular table. So here I am. To change the number of fields and their order, go to the connected SmartSuite view. So if I want to change how this information is pulling in, of course, it requires that I go back to the view inside of SmartSuite to work with all of that data. Now, because this is in early beta, it looks like some of these elements aren't quite being brought in quite how I would expect them to be. So I'm getting some warning signs here based on the name, the phone number, and the address. This is likely due to the fact that those particular field types are not being properly processed or read from the front-end tool inside of EasyPortal. So what we would need to do is first convert those field types over to standard text fields that I'm sure EasyPortal has an easier time reading. You'll notice that here, it's not struggling with the title. It's also not struggling with the email here. So these particular fields, I would want to revamp inside of my tool. So I might flip back inside of my SmartSuite account and take care of that rather than using, in this case, a full name field, which might be slightly difficult for EasyPortal to understand. I could replicate this or just add a new field here, and I'll make it a text field, and I'll call this name 2. For example, add the field here. I will highlight one of these and copy paste over here, get the names just filled out for text instead of the name field. Let's now hide this particular one. I will just go ahead and actually go to my field to display and remove it from the view. And I will reorder and bring name 2 up here. So now I've got name 2 in this view. Let's flip back to EasyPortal. And if I refresh my data once again, we see now that the name is being brought in appropriately. So the issue here, again, to my original assumption, was that it was having a difficult time reading that field type. So as you're testing this out, if you experience this as well, simply convert your data field type over to a text or another commonly used field type in order to bring in the information you need to EasyPortal. Now, I'm happy with the way this looks. I can move on over to my actions here. This is where I can establish certain things happening when people are accessing this data. So, for example, I could create a record. I could build this opportunity just by toggling right here. And when people would push this button, it would be prompting them to add the email and the name here and the title, and this information would be filled out and create a new record inside of our SmartSuite account. Similarly, we can add item buttons that have different types of actions. Here, I've added that action button in line with the table. So I could give some specific instructions to this particular button, and I can also allow people to delete information inside of that SmartSuite account. By toggling all three of these things on, I'm unlocking the full potential of actions that my users can take inside of the portal. By editing information, deleting information, and adding new information right into my SmartSuite dataset. Now lastly, I'll toggle into visibility here. This allows me to determine who has access to view this block. I can toggle it to just be logged in users for my app. I can say non-logged in users only can see this, or I can say everyone can see it, whether logged in or not. Now, as you can see, this is the first step in having a front-end portal for SmartSuite, so very excited to be announcing this and showcasing the capability that is currently available inside of the beta test. As I mentioned, EasyPortal is very early stages right now, so go ahead and sign up and start your account and start tinkering with it to start building a front end for your SmartSuite information. I hope you got a ton of value from this video. Of course, if you did, be sure you subscribe to the channel. And in the meantime, keep on building.